All right. Welcome, everybody. We're going to continue with Super Space Trash Blues. We're going to find out what's going on and try to keep going. Tonight's going to be a little harder, mostly because I'm at a loss at what to do here. I think I know what I want to do, but I'm not sure yet. I'm just checking what chapter we ended on, and it should have been 5. Yeah. Okay, so we're past 5. We're gonna start with 6 tonight. I think I'm gonna start with somebody else, but I'm not sure just yet, actually. This is a little harder tonight. I can't really place what I want to do. Let me see here. Excuse me, Frank. Okay. I actually need to change something real quick. It is not day 5. Creator dashboard, stream manager. Day 6. Excellent. That should be good to go. Need to stop distracting myself and keep going here. Thank you. Hey, Madison. Hope you're doing good. Today is day 6. Today is day 6, so we're on chapter 6. All the other chapters I was somewhat happy with. This one, though, it's okay. I'm not too enthused by it. It's just a... I just didn't know where I was going with it tonight. But let's go ahead. Let's go ahead and switch over to the website real quick so we can input our data. Keep up where we are. Okay. Let's see here. Okay. Alright. So, tonight we got 2,012 words. So, let's update that. 2,012 words. Writing at home. We'll say laptop, but I mean, we all know it's a PC. So, that's where we are there. I was feeling meh about it. Top in an hour, and it is 10:22. Update that progress. 24%. 11,000 words out of 500. Let's see here. So here's where we're supposed to be with 10,000 or 1,800, 11,800 higher, or 1,800 higher than we're supposed to be. We only needed 1605 and we got 2012. It shows here that the highest I wrote was day one with 2039. You know, I got back up there. I usually average about 1,980 words a day. It claims that if I keep this up, I'll be done November 25th instead of the 30th. And apparently 33 words per minute. So that's where we are there. Okay. Let me switch back over to this really quickly. Let me do myself a favor here. I have the master document over here. You can't see it. Let me copy this and put it over. Oh, let me copy this. Put it over to. Frank, you're killing me. This. Well, we'll save that. What we're gonna do is like after we're done, I'm going to put it away for probably about a year and then go from there. Alright. So as always, I'm gonna read through this and just try to get a feel for how it went. I'm gonna warn you, I got really into the whole hacking thing tonight. I don't know why. I think it's just part of it. It's when you have those details. So like, what'll probably happen is that when I go back, I won't have that in there, more than likely. Not that much. but it has opened up an avenue for me that I see a connection that I didn't see before that I'm probably gonna add to. Kind of ensure that this is gonna like connect and coalesce with them. Anyways, let's go ahead and jump into chapter 6. The 12 boxes of medical supplies had 1,000-year batteries that powered the security systems that kept the pressurized locks in place. Though it could have been forced open with one of Forge's many repair tools or smashed apart with the lender's strength, Astrid stood around listening to them talk and cleared her throat. "I'd like to give it a try and open them an easier way," she said. Everyone looked at her and Arden shrugged and flipped over a That's supposed to be Alden. flipped over a crate and sat down, resting his elbows on his knees. Forge wandered off to get something stronger to drink while Lindgren and Minsk started cleaning the moisture that had collected on the boxes. The water glistened in the dull glow of the yellow lights hanging above, and she could feel how cold they still were. "You liking that deck?" Lindra asked. Astrid could tell that there was no malice in the question. She could see that the orc's woman's green eyes were locked onto hers as Astrid pulled out the deck, activated the machine, and held up the keyboards, looking between everyone. "It feels nice," she said. "Which color do I use?" The way we were told was that the red is for quick, brutal work, and the blue is for those that want to be quiet and leave no trace behind, Alden said, and I don't know what any of that means. Astrid didn't either, but she pulled out the blue keyboard with old, worn keys. Some of them had faded away with use, and though she was sure that someone had used this keyboard a lot, it wasn't anyone around her. "Looks like you got some homework," Minsk said, "if you don't want to fight." Astrid nodded. She had fought the training robots all her life using her bonded sword, and though, before setting foot on the Valmont, she believed that she could have taken anyone. After Alindra had sent her reeling, she wasn't sure that there would be any chance against a real opponent. Though some of the crew could see that already, she wasn't about to tell anyone just in case she had to call their bluff. "I'll read up on all I can," Astrid said, "until we get to a place where we split ways." "That'll be extortion," Lindra said, "more than likely." "More than likely," Alden nodded, taking a drink from Forge, who reappeared with the flask. They passed it around to one another, and when Astrid reached for it, Alindra held it above her head and tisked. "You gotta keep your head on straight for this part," she said. "After that, you can have all that's left over." "Deal," Astrid nodded. In the bag, there were numerous attachments that she found, and she found one that plugged into the deck, and on the other end of it was a 4-foot cable with a silver card. Each of the boxes had card slots. She slipped the card into the first box and hit the enter on the key. The black screen started generating code in green letters, the manufacturer, creator, and year it was produced. Then there was a blank screen waiting the commands. Alindra pulled out the data slate and handed it to her. There were a list of different types of rudimentary codes that were used for different operations. She found one called Lockboxer, and she activated it. The screen went black again for a moment, and then a new code came up with a set of commands. "Don't get discouraged," Minsk said. "This has a steep learning curve." "I'll wager 6 credits on 10 minutes, Alindra said, "per box." 20 minutes, Minsk said, smiling. 5 minutes, Forge replied. "I'm not betting against someone that hasn't shown their hand," Alden replied. Astrid shook her head and took a look at the black screen. She entered a few commands to activate the first set of programs to start decoding the administrator username and password. While that was running, she started checking all the different variables embedded into the code that may be waiting on the other side of the lock. There were systems made to defend the deck and user, systems to make it look like the user was an automated file share program. The list went on, but she imagined that these lock boxes were simple. There was a beep when the administrator username and password were found in this single box. She could see where the code was typed in. It was basic, tight, and to the point. There had not been any flourishes or any other anti-theft protocols in place. Mostly, she assumed that most people would take the time to do what she was doing, would not take the time to do what she was doing. She typed in the commands to unlock the box before hitting enter, and she could see a series of numbers that identified the certain box to the card. She would have to identify each box number, copy it over to the card, and then activate the card reader to trick it into thinking it was the correct set of identification. 10 minutes, Alindra sighed. "I had more faith in you." Astrid looked up and realized that she had been going on for a lot longer than she had thought. There was something about staring at the code that brought her peace, as if that's what she was supposed to be doing. It was the most natural thing that ever occurred to her. She changed the code, activated the identification programs, and the box clicked open. She pulled out the card, and instead of looking inside, she slipped the card into the next one and restarted the process. This time, she didn't pause, and the box hissed open at 8 minutes. There had to be a better way, she thought, to do this. During the third box, she rewrote the code completely, which took her 20 minutes. She tried to create a key card that would be read by all boxes the same, but for some reason, the code wouldn't be processed in the testing phase. She sighed. "What are you doing?" Forge said. "There's a lot more on that screen than before you started this." testing something, Alindra said. Sorry. Test after test failed and she growled. Something was limiting her deck, keyboard, and card shunt, but she didn't know what it could be. Instead of going back to the original code, she decided to force it to run against protocol warnings to see what would happen. She hit enter and watched as the code generated, duplicating onto the card. The next step was to duplicate the card into the same small security system of the box. There was a hiss followed by the smell of melted wires. Error appeared on the deck screen and Forge coughed. He stood up, walked over to the box, and tried to pull out the card, but the plastic had fused itself into the slot. You broke it. Alindra shook her head and stood up. It should have worked. Astrid held the power button to shut the deck down. Everything was set, but the deck wouldn't process. Because the deck is old, Arden said, and there's no one left to keep it up. There was a long silence. Would that have been me? Winston chimed through the speakers. Nice guess, Alden said. He wasn't smiling. But you can't do that anymore. I could try to access my memories and help Astrid learning the programming needed, Winston said. No, Arden replied. It's Alden. Why do I keep doing that? It's weird. But you're going to get every bit of information in the IIN that you can find to help her. Consider it done, Winston replied. So what now? Astrid stood up. We do it the fun way, Forge smiled and flipped over his crowbar. They spent the next 20 minutes forcing open the boxes and taking inventory of what they had found. There were medical-grade medications set to treat dust rot, fungal lung, and brain swells. On top of that, there was large quantities of basic antibiotics for all species. Why would they only have these specific treatments? Astrid asked while she typed out the inventory in a data slate that was mounted on the wall. Because these supplies were for a colonizing group heading out for a world that was a hostile environment, Mink said. There are worlds out there that in every biome it's trying to kill you. And from what I can see, this one was a tropical and desert planet. If this is a medical transport, Alden said as he slipped the bottles into the new containers, then I wonder where the actual ship got off to. Not sure, Alindra said. We could go back and check the logs. Might not be a bad idea, Forge said. We could find some salvage on a colony ship. A lot of dead on a colony ship, Mink said. Alden stood there adjusting the items they had received into nice little rows, and then closing the containers and locking them up. He was looking at the ceiling, his thumb running along the hilt of his sword. Entire families potentially taken by the void, he said. Lost out there with no one to claim them. We could find them some peace, Alindra nodded. Let them go. Fine, Arden said. Alindra and Astrid suit back up. Hell's Captain, Alindra sighed. Back in there with her? Though Astrid said nothing, she agreed wholeheartedly. It didn't take long for them to suit up. The rest of the crew went back to whatever they were doing, and Alden went to the command center to keep watch on them to see if there were any surprise visitors. Again, they stood in the dual airlock and waited until it was safe. Winston fired back up the power, and they moved through the floating debris to the command center. It was a large room with six massive plate glass windows that were protected by sliding metal shutters. All but one of the six squares were intact. There was a massive hole where something had torn through the metal, broken through the glass, and exploded. There were destroyed computer systems lining the wall and shards of glass suspended in zero gravity. See if you can get the navigation systems online, Winston, Alindra said. Understood, Winston replied. All the systems in the room lit up momentarily, sending an array of colors through the pieces of glass, sending rainbow reflections on the ceiling. Then all of them went out one at a time until there was only one still left. It was a square system that was in the center of the room. Both moved toward it, and Alindra activated the data logs. They watched as it fed them information. From what Astrid gathered, the ship was a single vessel sent to check on a settlement on planet V-33. It was 14 jumps away, which took another 6 days. The ship had been off course for 2 months. Those folks are either dead or close to it, Alindra said after relaying the information to Alden. There's probably no use, Alden said. But what if they're alive, Astrid said. We don't have the fuel or time, Alden replied. They might need us, she replied. We don't need them, Alindra said and powered off the navigation system. Incoming, Alden said. Shit, Alindra growled and pulled free one of her last pistols at her hip. How long? 20 minutes, Alden replied. We can't outrun this one, Winston said. Play dead, Alinda growled. Decouple and play dead. She said that. That's less than an hour, Alden replied. We won't need any more than that, Alinda growled, and she started moving down toward the entrance. Astrid followed. She looked through the massive hole to see a much smaller ship coming their way. Its sleek body was illuminated by its lights. She could hear a loud static noise, and Alinda assured her that they had killed any communications with the Valmont as the Malamont went dark and decoupled. We're about to have company, she smiled, and even through her glass helmet, Astrid thought she looked a little too eager for violence. Okay. That one's alright. I didn't like it that much. It just felt like it was kind of one of those chapters that just might end up cutting or merging. I kind of, like, I made a little bit, I don't want to show you yet, but I've made a little more notes. That I might use here and here, but I don't know yet. I'm probably for real going to jump perspectives tomorrow, just to kind of keep some kind of tension running, I think, and go from there. But yeah, so that was tonight. Again, we're still a little bit ahead of the game. There is a chance that we're going to drop a bit, and that's okay. That'll happen. We'll get behind, and then we'll play catch up. But right now we're ahead. Let's celebrate that. Enjoyed me some Cider Boys beer. It was pretty good. Anyways, thanks for dropping in and checking on me. I'll be here every night this month until we are finished. If you have any ideas or anything that you would like to learn about these characters, let me know and we'll try to generate that together. So until tomorrow, I hope you guys have a good night and enjoy the rest of your day tomorrow.